classroom, we're going to be talking about the environment and the horrible things that are happening to it.
To start, we are going to talk about deforestation.
Deforestation is when people cut down trees, and this can normally result in habitat loss for Earth's rare and endangered wildlife.
Animals such as the tiger, lemur and the ocelot are struggling to survive and will continue to decrease in their numbers if nothing happens.
But we can help.
Hi, I'm Caitlin. And how can I help contribute to saving our planet?
You can use the 3 R's.
Well, what do you mean?
The 3 R's, reduce, reuse, recycle.
This means that you should cut down on how much waste you are producing.
You can turn off lights and plug at night to reduce the amount of electricity you're using. You can reuse old clothes and toys and give them to a charity shop.
This is a good alternative to throwing them away.
Materials such as cardboard and paper can be put in a recycling bin and turned into something new.
This saves us having to cut down more trees to make paper.
We put together this iMovie as a way to show what things are happening to our rainforests.
We need to stop it.
And fast.
Do we really want to think about our animals becoming extinct?
Well, we need to start facing the reality of our animals. Could all ocean animals become extinct sometime in the future?
Our expectation of just polluting the water and nothing happening will last us longer, won't it?
Well, we really need to start facing the reality.
Although most people are aware of air pollution, ocean pollution is still a thing.
Although we like our beautiful animals, such as whales, dolphins and turtles, there are many other risks this can cause.
Water animals will become extinct.
The pollution in the water will be really bad.
Drinking water will become unsafe and unsanitary.
Well, it already has in the past. There are many diseases that this has started because of unsanitary water.
Here are some pictures we found of polluted ocean water.
Thank you.
question is, what do you think about plastic pollution?
Well, I don't like it because it can get in the sea and stuff, you know, because, and then it kills animals because they get it stuck around their necks and stuff, and it's just affecting the environment in a bad way.
What do you think about plastic pollution?
I don't think it's really horrible, and people just chucking it in the ocean's terrible, and just, it's not good for the environment.
What do you think about plastic pollution?
I think that plastic pollution is very bad because plastic injures animals.
The next question is, what do you think is causing the issue?
Just people being lazy and not bothering to put things in the bin. And they're like, oh, I'll just leave that there, and then, oh, it's blown off into the sea and everywhere else. That is affected badly.
What do you think is causing the issue?
Just people being reckless of throwing plastic in the ocean. When they go to the seaside, they just chuck it on the floor. And bins probably falling over by the wind.
Thank you very much. What do you think is causing the issue?
When people throw rubbish into the sea and it eventually finds its way to the animals.
Okay, thank you. Is plastic pollution an issue?
Most definitely. You've only got to have watched all the nature programs that we've had recently, such as Planet Earth, and I think that we as a nation have definitely got to do something about it.
Would you consider helping preventing the problem?
Definitely. As a school, I've already started talking to the catering company, and we're looking at various things such as straws, packaging, etc. that they're using. And I think longer term, as a school, we may well need to look at what we're doing with regard to water bottles and the use of plastic in that way as well.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
We really hope this video can help raise awareness of this topic, as it is getting quite severe.
Thank you for listening.
Bye.
Hi, I'm Amy.
And I'm Caitlin.
Today we will be talking about air pollution / global warming.
Many people are aware of air pollution, however they're doing nothing to stop it.
Air pollution is not visible but causing much damage.
Can we work together to make the air clean again and keep our ozone layer?
As Caitlin mentioned earlier, the ozone layer is breaking.
The ozone layer is our protection of our Earth. It keeps the oxygen in and is the line between space and Earth.
The repercussions of breaking our ozone layer are devastating.
Well, what are they?
The ozone layer keeps the oxygen in Earth's atmosphere. If it breaks, we will lose our oxygen and there may be no life on Earth.
Did you know Beijing spent $2.7 billion trying to clear their air?
No, but that's incredible. That's a true example of commitment to saving our planet. We have made an iMovie to show the devastating effects of air pollution.
Thank you.
some interviews to show the public's opinions. How do you think we can reduce air pollution?
So locally, in terms of towns and cities, more people cycling to work. You've got the cycle to work scheme where people can buy bikes and then obviously get to work that way. Walking, pedestrianised zones in town centres will help to reduce the number of cars around shopping areas, which will reduce air pollution around there. Okay, also you can also have big open spaces, so lots of places like parks with lots of vegetation in help to capture a lot of the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, so and therefore release oxygen and reduce air pollution in the area.
How do you think we can reduce air pollution?
I think we can use better sources for our engines, and I think we can, like car shares, so we use up less energy.
How do you think we can reduce air pollution?
We could use car lifts and ride bikes.
So car share?
Yeah.
What is your opinion about air pollution?
It's obviously not a good thing. We need to do our best to reduce it. People cycling to work and catching the bus rather than driving in like I do on my own. I need to maybe car share a little bit more. All those little things can help. So yeah, it's obviously not a good thing, and it can cause all sorts of respiratory diseases, asthma, etc., which obviously aren't very good in society.
What is your opinion about air pollution?
I think it's really bad for the world because it's using up our oxygen.
Okay. What is your opinion about air pollution?
I think it's really bad because it means that it pollutes the air that we breathe, and trees and plants can't breathe proper air, neither can we.
In your opinion, what country do you think causes the most air pollution?
I think it's the USA.
Why?
Because they're one of the loads of people in the USA have cars and they use those as means of transport, so I think it's the USA.
Thank you. What country do you think causes the most air pollution?
The USA or China.
Why?
Because they're the most popular countries.
Thank you for joining us. What country do you think causes the most air pollution?
Countries that have thousands and thousands and thousands of cars on the road in very small areas. So we're talking here really overpopulated countries, but also places that have access to oil quite often pollute. So we could have places like Pakistan, Qatar, China, certain places in the US, but air pollution is quite hard to define in terms of on a country scale, because obviously there are urban and rural areas. The rural areas are going to have less air pollution, and the urban areas where there are more cars and more people burning fossil fuels, etc., that's going to cause more air pollution. So it's hard to nail down a country, but big cities, mega cities, will definitely have higher concentrations of air pollution.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thanks for watching.
Bye.